I am Sangeeta Sen, Assistant Professor, AAA Department. Today I am going to discuss a topic from electromagnetic field subject, that is Maxwell's equation for time varying field. So before going to the detailed topic, we should know where we are using Maxwell's equation. So and what is the difference between static field and time varying field? So if we consider static field, there is no induced EMF. Static field doesn't make a current flow through the circuit. But when it comes to time varying field, the time varying field will be producing a voltage or EMF. So this will be causing an EMF, and this EMF will be producing a current flow through a closed circuit. Is the main difference between static field and time varying field. Static field doesn't make any current flow, but time varying field produces an induced EMF. Because of the induced EMF, we will be getting a current flow through a closed circuit. So why we are using Maxwell equation, or where we are using this Maxwell equation? Most of the electrical machines based on this equation. So this Maxwell equation is related to Faraday's law. So as we all know, Faraday's law is related to the time-varying magnetic field. So according to Faraday's law, the induced EMF, how it is producing? So as per Faraday's law, whenever the conductor cuts the magnetic flux, EMF will be induced. And that induced EMF is proportional to rate of change of flux linkage. So Faraday introduced two losses. First, you know, whenever the conductor cuts the flux, EMF will be inducing, and this induced EMF will be proportional to rate of change of flux linkage. So this flux linkage we can represent by an equation N into phi, and if we substitute this equation here, EMF will be equal to rate of change of flux linkage. Psi is replaced with N phi, and this minus sign is related to Lenz law. So as per Lenz law, the induced EMF will be opposing the force producing it. That is the indication of minus sign. So here, as per Faraday's law, EMF will be proportional to minus divided by N into phi. That means flux linkage. And from the magnetism, we can write phi is equal to surface integral B dot ds. Surface integral B dot ds. So if we utilize that equation in EMF equation, B EMF is equal to minus N into d by dt of surface integral B dot ds. So based on this relationship, now we can derive the Maxwell equation in time varying field. So previously in the first units we studied about Maxwell equation in electrostatic field. Now when it comes to time varying field, it will be relating to flux phi. So from the last equation, B EMF equal to minus N into d by dt of surface integral B dot ds. And in electrostatic, we studied that in a closed loop, the EMF induced B EMF equal to closed line integral E dot dl. So as per electrostatics, we derived the equation when we studied about potential, electric potential. So V EMF is equal to closed line integral E dot dl. If we equate this equation here, we will get line integral E dot dl equal to minus m into d by dt surface integral v dot ds. So in electromagnetic field, we have to use two main equations that are, or two analyses, those are divergence theorem and Stokes theorem. Divergence theorem and Stokes theorem. So these are the two theorems we will be applying in electromagnetic field. So one will be converting, Stokes theorem will be converting the line integral to surface integral. So now we will apply the Stokes theorem here. So it can convert this line integral into surface integral. That is, after applying Stokes theorem, line integral will be changed into surface integral. Line integral will be converting into surface integral. So if we apply Stokes theorem, this will be surface integral del cross E ds equal to minus n d by dt surface integral v dot ds. So from this equation, we can cancel out certain terms because both the side we are having surface integral. So finally we will get minus n into d by dt of d. So here, if n is equal to 1, if n is equal to 1, del cross E equal to minus d by dt of d. If we take in partial differentiation form, del cross E will be equal to minus rho v by rho t. Minus sign is again related to Lenz's law. So this is Maxwell's equation in time varying field, and this is Maxwell's first equation. Another equation is related to displacement current. So once again, I will repeat here, Maxwell equation for time varying field. Time varying field is nothing but this will be inducing a voltage and hence it produces a current flow through a closed circuit. Then we are using Faraday's equation. Through Faraday's equation, we are deriving Maxwell equation. So as per Faraday's law, whenever the conductor cuts the magnetic flux, EMF will be inducing. And the induced EMF will be proportional to rate of change of flux linkage. The flux linkage we are replacing with the equation n into phi. So we will be getting the equation in terms of B. So this minus sign is related to Lenz's law. If number of turns n is equal to 1, del cross E equal to minus dV by dt. So this equation represents Maxwell's equation in time varying field. That's the equation in time varying. Now everyone will be having doubt how the flux is changing, how the EMF is inducing. So when it comes to electrical machines like the electrical generator, motor, transformer, everywhere we are using Faraday's law. And we generally study that whenever the conductor cuts the magnetic flux, EMF will be induced. So to induce the EMF, we should change the flux. So how it is happening? So there are three methods. varying, first method, varying stationary loop. Stationary loop in a time varying field. So in the simple meaning, the conductor will be stationary, the flux will be changing or magnetic field will be changing. Second one is, there will be a moving loop in a time varying field. Time varying field. So generally we will call it as transformer EMF, motional EMF, etc. So the last one is both conductor and magnetic field will be moving. So these are the three methods to induce EMF. So first we will study about stationary loop in a time varying field. So this EMF generally we will call it as transformer EMF. As we all know, transformer working principle, that is mutual induction principle, based on electromagnetic field theory, we will call a stationary loop in a time varying field. Conductor will be stationary, magnetic field will be changing. So whenever the rate of change of flux happens, EMF will be inducing. So here we will call this as transformer EMF. So how we can derive the equation for transformer EMF? So first one is transformer EMF. EMF equation of transformer everyone knows, but based on electromagnetic field theory, we will relate transformer EMF to Maxwell equation. So we know that as per Faraday's law, induced EMF is proportional to rate of change of flux linkage, then psi is equal to n into phi. So EMF, B EMF equal to minus d by dp of n phi. We can take n outside, so B EMF is equal to minus n d phi by dp. Then come magnetostatics, phi is equal to surface integral B dot ds. If you substitute that, V EMF is equal to minus N d by dt of surface integral B dot ds. Then from electrostatic, EMF is equal to, since it is in a closed loop, E dot dl equal to line integral E dot dl is equal to minus n d by dt b dot ds. So here apply Stokes theorem, then del cross E surface integral del cross E ds equal to minus n d by dt surface integral B dot ds. So we can cancel certain term. Finally, we will get the equation del cross E is equal to minus d by dt of B. In partial differential form, del cross E is equal to minus dou B by dou B. So this is also known as point form of Maxwell equation, and this equation we are deriving from Faraday's law, and this relationship is known as transformer EMF in electromagnetic field theory.